What's going on, HF, and welcome to a brand new edition of the Friday VTV Show. I'm your host for today, Kennedy Hardy. I hope everyone enjoyed the day off yesterday, but at the same time, I hope you took some time to honor our veterans. As always, we still have a jam-packed and entertaining show with segments from all around the school. So let's not waste any more time, and as always, let's see that intro. To begin today's show, let's take a look at our hockey team and their current standings.
The HF hockey team is off to a great start this year and added to that great start by picking up a win last Saturday versus AWFM. The wins are coming in at a much higher rate than last year, and a recent change the team made has shown that effect. Last year at the varsity level, the team struggled against their competition, so this year HF changed things up to bring a better experience for the players. The team is playing a JV schedule in order to stay in games and compete against every team that they face.
Definitely just the team like bonding, and we have more practice time this year, so we've gotten more time together to work together and to practice, which really grew us as a team together.
The schedule change has brought immense changes within the team's record and ability compared to the previous season at the varsity level. Last season, the team managed to score just 3 goals throughout the whole year and didn't win any games. So this year, the team is regularly scoring over 3 goals a game and has a winning record.
Personally, I think our strengths were just our passing out on the ice.
Our continuous enthusiasm as the periods rolled through, because we were up there, we were feeling good, so we played good.
We gave it our all out there, so I think that's what started us off good.
The team is 5-1 in their last 6 games and hosts Nazareth this Saturday at the HF Ice Arena. The team beat Nazareth 9-3 the first time they faced them, so this should be a very good game. If you want to come out and support the hockey team, their game is 7:30 this Saturday and there is no entry fee.
The theater department at HF has been working extremely hard to get back on track with their musical, The Lion King Jr., after the director, Mr. Rose, got COVID. They had started production for this musical even before their most recent play, The Secret in the Wings, but had to come to a halt for a whole month in order to still have a performance on schedule. Now they have had just 2 weeks to prepare for opening night. Everyone in the show is excited for the performance, but also have faced some challenges in preparation for it. Mr. Rose and the students in the musical have expressed their positive outlook as well as some concerns for the production.
We had to stop our production and end up changing our performance dates, and it was a little crazy, but we're excited to be back and doing the show 2 months later.
It's kind of just like remembering what we did and then picking up from there. But it definitely is kind of weird to like stop, then do a different show, then continue the first one.
The only thing I'm really scared about is like someone messing up and then having to improvise, because like that's never ends up being good.
We pretty much blocked most of the show and did the dances and everything, learned all the music back in September, and now that we have about 6 or 7 rehearsals, we are just running, and today we're starting our tech.
Even though we don't have that much time to put the rest of it together, I think it'll come together really, really well.
In shows in the past, it's always like, oh my gosh, we're not ready, and then we end up being perfectly fine, and it actually is a killer show, so I'm excited to see what happens.
This was just a perfect show for our community and for young children in our community to be able to come out and see, and that's why we do a children's theater piece every year, and we're really excited about it.
The whole cast and crew feel confident that they will be able to pull the performance together, but the only way you'll find out is if you go to see their production of The Lion King Jr. So come out and support your fellow classmates to see this high school take on a traditional movie.
Keep up the amazing work and effort. Let's keep rolling and take a look at this year's SNHS Ofrendas.
Dia de los Muertos, also known as Day of the Dead, is a 2-day holiday observed by those with Mexican heritage that reunites the living and the dead. Dia de los Muertos is celebrated with the creation of ofrendas or offerings. Families create ofrendas to honor their departed family members that have passed. These altars are decorated with beautiful flowers, photos, unique items that represent the departed, and the favorite foods of those being honored. The offerings are believed to encourage visits from the land of the dead, as the departed souls hear their prayers, smell their foods, and join in celebrations. The Spanish National Honor Society has created ofrendas to celebrate Dia de los Muertos for a couple of years now. This year's Ofrendas offered Chadwick Boseman, an award-winning actor most popularly known for his role in Marvel's Black Panther, Cameron Boyce, an actor most popularly known for his role in Disney's Jessie, and the victims of COVID-19. SNHS members Ellie Bojakowski, Catherine Madden, and Miranda Douglas speak about their experiences making the Ofrendas and what they mean to them.
It was important to me to make the Ofrenda because we lost him, and he was very important in many different communities, and he was an inspiration to many different people.
Yeah, creating the Ofrenda for victims of COVID-19 was really fun. We had five people in our group, and it was nice to celebrate the lives lost from COVID-19.
Setting up the Ofrenda for Cameron Boyce was a wonderful experience for my group members and I. It was an amazing way to commemorate the life of Cameron Boyce, who is a childhood role model of ours. And it's also great to celebrate Hispanic culture and the life of Cameron Boyce.
The Ofrendas can be seen on the second floor of the North Building outside of the assistant principal's office. Stop by and see the celebration of lives loved by many. For VTV, I'm Kyla Emery.
WHFH at 88.5 FM is a radio show here at HF. We have shows every day from 3 to 9 p.m. Today we talk to Mac and Kennedy to get a deeper look into their radio show and the radio show industry itself.
Our show is about a little bit of everything. We talk about pop culture, music, news, current events, different cultural things. In like recent times, we've been starting to get more personal.
Yeah, a pretty funny, pretty entertaining show where it's just black voices that get to be in this space.
Oftentimes we move to educate in our segments. Like, we may talk about a certain topic and talk down on it and how you should do it, but beforehand, we're gonna tell you what said topic is. Preparation! It is the hardest and most important part of the show. Finding stuff to talk about, finding music, and then planning out segments, planning out how long songs are gonna be in between each segment. It is like watching grass grow. It is expensive and it's annoying.
The easiest part about it is once you get into the flow of things, that synchronization, that's it.
The first 30 minutes is nothing but anxiety.
It's just,
oh my God, this is so stressful, what are we doing? But like, after like the first 30 minutes, we get into the vibe of the show, and it just goes off without a hitch.
You can listen to them every other Wednesday from 3 to 5 p.m. and tune in to other stations at 88.5 FM.
The girls' varsity basketball season is officially here. The team is full of returning players, and one Viking has been recognized at a national level. Alyssa Latham, a junior point guard for the Vikings, was ranked in the top 60 basketball players in the United States over the past summer by ESPN. Latham was surprised to hear this news.
It felt great. At first I was surprised, but it feels good just to be recognized.
Latham is a third-year varsity player for the Vikings and believes that her coaches and team are the ones that help her work her best when playing basketball, and she hopes to make it to state this year.
Mostly like my coaches and my teammates helped me get to where I am.
The Vikings were 6-3 last year in a shortened COVID season. This year, both coaches and players are hoping experience leads them to more victories in the win column.
This year, I just hope to bring wins. Like, my goal is to get downstate and win a championship. That's what I hope to bring this season.
The team's first home game is against Crete Monee this coming Monday, November 15th at 6:30 p.m. It'll be the first chance to see one of the top players in the country on the court. Hope to see you there.
Thanks everyone for the helpful and useful information. Now, on our next segment, we will be showcasing many fashion trends. So get that money ready. Well, only if you like fashion.
I would describe my fashion as something that just expresses my mood. Like when I wake up and I'm like, oh, I want to put this on because I'm in a good mood today, or today is going to be a good day, so I want to put this on. I get my inspiration from me, myself, and I, because I feel as if you put certain stuff on and it makes you feel good, so why try to copy somebody else's style, because you never know how it actually fits or how it's going to actually look on you. It just looks good on that person, so put stuff on that makes you feel good. Fashion to me is what helps you express who you are, because no matter what you put on, if you feel good in it and you feel like you look good, then it just, that's your fashion. I'm Reagan Gibson, and this is Walk Your Runway on VTV.
OMG, now I really want to buy something. Anyways, it's been quite a while since we had a new episode of What's Your Name, and sadly, we still don't have a new episode for you. However, instead, we check back in with the couples to see if the connection they made lasted outside of the show. Let's check it out.
Okay, so after the show, me and Mackenzie, we texted, and we was cool. We was keeping up with each other, all that. But then things didn't really work out. We went our separate ways, and it's all love. And now we're here. Nah, I'm good.
Any final words for the show, What's Your Name?
I appreciate the show and what it helped me with. And yeah, get on it.
So you guys know that I said that self-love is the best kind of love, and I stand by that. You know, I see Charlie sometimes and I'm like, no. And I see Chase sometimes and I'm like, definitely not. And you know, I'm comfortable with my decision, you know. I wouldn't say I'm looking for someone kind of off the market, but you know, it is what it is. My final words for the show are, you know, we should all choose self-love, but a little outside love can't hurt.
You have an outside lover?
So what happened at the show was, like, we didn't really connect the way I wanted to. So, and plus, like, when I watched the show from the last time we was here, yeah, I didn't like it, so I just never reached out, and he didn't reach out either, and I'm not a chaser, so, yeah. No, I hate everybody. So my future advice is just be very sure and be very careful about who you pick, or if you get chosen, how you go about it. That's pretty much it.
Okay, so basically what happened after the show was that we ain't really talked. Like, I seen them during the show and that was it. Ain't seen them ever again. Don't wanna see them. We ain't got no What's Your Name yet. We getting there. We getting there. My final words for the show is, I love y'all, but y'all little boo things wasn't it. And that's final. Because we don't like them. Okay? Brain, yeah. I think that I got what you needed. I'm
willing to do anything that you please. I'm trying to get down to. Amazing. I just always love watching that show. Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today's VTV Friday show. We hope to see you back here next week for all the new episodes of VTV. I'm Kennedy Hardy, and from here and everyone at VTV, have a wonderful weekend.